Blockchain is one of the hottest topic these days, and we are sure in coming days its popularity is going to increase. So in this video, what we are going to understand, we'll try to understand what is blockchain and what is Bitcoin. Okay, we'll look into the basic definitions so that we can understand the whole concept. Then we'll look into the role of miners, okay, behind all these transactions. We'll take an example of Bitcoin transaction so that we can understand the whole life cycle of blockchain transactions. Okay, so we'll try to understand why this is so popular and how it is going to change our coming future. So let's start with this video, and we'll start with basic definitions first. Whenever we discuss with anyone and we talk about blockchain and we ask what is blockchain, most of the time we get an answer, are you talking about Bitcoin? That is a common response we get most of the time. But point here is Bitcoin is not blockchain and blockchain is not Bitcoin. But these two definitions are totally interrelated with each other, and both are responsible for each other's success. So in this video, we'll try to understand how these two are interconnected and how the popularity of blockchain as well as Bitcoin is increasing. Okay, so the main agenda of this video is blockchain. Okay, first let us try to understand the concept behind blockchain. First, if you look at this picture, we have a chain of blocks. Okay, now we need to understand what is this chain and what these blocks represent. Okay, each block is recording information in such a way that it is very difficult, or you can say impossible, to change or cheat the system. Once the information is stored or encrypted in these blocks, nobody can change. Okay, we'll try to understand how this process is done, but this is just a definition. Okay, these blocks are having all the information related to that particular transaction. Then the most important thing is, once this block is generated, this is available to entire network. Okay, this is an open book, and all the information is available to everyone, whoever is involved into those transactions. Okay, even if you are not involved, then also you can track and see each and every transaction very easily. You don't need anybody's approval to look into all these informations. Okay, so we can say there is no single authority who is representing this blockchain. This is an open system. Anybody can make transactions, anybody can see the records, and nobody can change the information which is stored inside each and every block. Okay, whenever new transactions are made, new blocks will be generated, and this will again be part of that chain. So this is chain of blocks. Blocks are having each and every information, and the system is very transparent, available to each and everyone who is a part of that blockchain. So now let us try to understand what is Bitcoin. Whenever we talk about Bitcoin, blockchain always come into picture, and whenever we talk about blockchain, Bitcoin is always there. So let us try to understand what this whole concept is. Bitcoin was came into picture after the global recession in 2008. It was known to everyone since 2009. Okay, this is just a computer file which can be stored in a digital wallet on your mobile or your laptop or your computer. Anywhere you can save it and you can send it to anyone. Okay, so this is a decentralized digital currency without a central bank or single administrator. As we discussed the basic concepts behind blockchain, the whole things, all concepts are connected with Bitcoin also. So Bitcoin is a blockchain, right? It is just a file which you can save on your computer. So the point is, now the first very important point is, this was the first decentralized digital currency which came into existence. Okay, it is believed that it was created by Satoshi Nakamoto, but nobody till date has met him, this person, in person. So in 2009 it came into the picture, right? The point which is the basic TRP of Bitcoin is its restricted creation and management. Okay, this is just a program which is already there into existence. You can run it, but the point is you cannot mine more than 21 million of Bitcoins. Okay, as the time is passing, the difficulty level of this program which is used for mining the Bitcoin is increasing. So looking at the current complexity of that program, it is assumed that the last Bitcoin will be mined in 2140. Okay, so this is how the complexity is there at current scenario. Now this is peer-to-peer open ledger. As we discussed during discussion of basic fundamental of blockchains, Bitcoin is also same manner. It is just a software, and each and every transaction is validated by the miners. Okay, they miners are nothing but they are solving the mathematical problem, and once they solve that problem, that they get some reward and more Bitcoins are mined also, right? So that is the only thing we'll discuss in detail in next slide. In this, we just want to understand that this is an open ledger where the validated transactions are available, and those transactions can be seen by anybody on this blockchain. Okay, then hash code and algorithm. This is the basic fundamental behind all these blockchain transactions. Every transaction will be attached with hash code. Okay, there is an algorithm, hash algorithm, which is so complicated that once the miners run this program, they will attach hash code with each and every transaction. That hash code is nothing but a mathematical solution which has verified the transactions. So this will be encrypted in such a way that even reverse engineering cannot be done to tamper the transaction details. Okay, so that is why we call it hack proof. These transactions, once made, nobody can change it. Once these are verified by miners through these software programs, once these mathematical solutions are available, and once we say these transactions are verified, nobody can reverse these transactions. Okay, even the hackers are not able to do this, because the hash algorithms are programmed in such a way that reverse engineering is not possible. Even a small comma or space if we add into this program, that will make a drastic change into the outcomes. So there is no scope of change. Once the transaction is done, it is done. So that is the beauty of this blockchain, especially on Bitcoin blockchains. As we discussed, the complexity of mining Bitcoin is increasing day by day. Now just look at these two pictures. This is how the hardware requirements are there. Okay, these labs are having hundreds of chips who are used to mine the Bitcoins or any other cryptocurrency. So basically, if you have a miner's PC and you are in between the sender and receiver, okay, once miners are verifying the details, they will be getting some rewards in return of verifying the transactions. So this is just a basic behind the miner's role, where a lot of hardware requirements are there, a lot of electricity requirements are there. That is why there are debates related to heat generated by all these processors which are used to mine the cryptocurrencies. So now let us look at the life cycle of transactions on blockchain. Okay, for example, there is a sender who want to send few bitcoins to one of his friends here. So how these currencies will move on blockchain? Okay, first, once this is sent from a sender PC, this will enter into the miners pool. Okay, miners pool is nothing but a group of miners who are associated with each other so that they can manage the complexity of program together. Okay, not a single, it is very difficult for a single miner to verify the transaction. That is why they are into miner pools these days, so that they can manage the expenditure of all the processors required, all the electricity required, and all the space requirements. So they are available in the form of miners pool. So this transaction enters into the miners pool. They look into each and every transaction. First, they verify whether the sender has those many bitcoins with him or not. Okay, they have record of all the past transactions also. Then they verify, they solve the problem, mathematical problem, they attach the mathematical solution along with that, and they create the blocks. Okay, once these are validated, they look into each and every aspect of that transaction which are there in the software, and once this mathematical problem is solved, then the block creation is there, which will be then part of that blockchain. Once this is done, then this transaction will be completed. Okay, so most of the time Bitcoin takes 10 minutes to complete one transaction. So every 10 minutes you can say another block is created, right? So this block is not representing one single transaction, but it is a group of transactions. So once this block is completed, this will be available to all in the online ledger. So this is how these transactions are carried out on blockchain. Now let us look at various solutions which we get on blockchain. Okay, why this blockchain is popular and why this popularity is increasing and how this is going to change our futures in coming days. Okay, so first of all, what are various solutions we are getting? First is transaction fee. Okay, when there is no middleman, no central agency, no RBI, no centralized system is required, so these transaction fees will be lowered or maybe eliminated totally. Okay, this is the topmost benefit of using blockchain transactions, because we can verify all the transactions, we can see all the transactions, we have all the details in encrypted form which can be used at any time. So these middlemen are not required. So that is why this transaction fee will drastically go down. Then double payment. Okay, suppose somebody is having $500 and he wants to send $400 to this one and $500 to this one. So double spending may be possible on centralized system, which is totally eliminated in blockchain. Okay, this is not possible because the miners will always verify first whether this amount is available or not. Then there will be a complexity into the program which will be solved through softwares. Then only this transaction will be carried out. Okay, if this is not available, then this transaction will be rejected. Okay, so this double payment is not there. Then financial crisis. As you know, when there is a limit over the quantity of cryptos, for example Bitcoin, as we discussed, only 21 million bitcoins can be mined, then the whole system will remain balanced. Okay, we know maximum quantity, so based on that demand and supply, based on that demand and supply, the prices will always fluctuate. So but at the same time, we will be having a lot of things which are damaging our current financial system, which will be eliminated in blockchain systems. Then hack proof. As we discuss, each and every transaction is having hash coding using hash algorithm. So each and every transaction is safe. All the information, all the transaction details are encrypted inside that block on blockchain. So these transactions are safe. Nobody can do any tampering with respect to any transaction. That means these transaction details are safe on blockchain. Nobody can tamper all these things. So these few benefits which are there, which are going to be implemented into various sections. Just think about, if we have all the financial transactions on blockchain, we don't need banks. Okay, we don't need insurance companies, we don't need tourism companies, okay, who are into booking all these packages and all. So these applications of blockchain are going to stay, and this is going to change our future in coming days. So this is how these blockchain is going to change our future. So thank you for watching. I hope this blockchain concept is clear to everyone. See you in the next part.